There isn't a whole lot chemicals can do for you if you decide to jump on a grenade to save your army buddies. But what modern chemistry and genetics might be able to do, at least someday, is turn you from skinny private into Captain America. First off, let's not call what Steve Rogers was injected with a serum. That's usually some milky yellow mixture that can be isolated from blood that's not plasma. Although, calling it a super serum does sound cool. Wait, this kind of looks like pee. Can we change that? Next, we need to know what super soldier juice, that doesn't sound right at all, super soldier formula actually does. In the Marvel Universe, the first super soldier formula was created as a part of Operation Rebirth by scientist Abraham Erskine and was given intravenously to Steve Rogers. After administration, Rogers was placed in a Vita Ray chamber and was bombarded with radiation. He emerged not superhuman, but at the absolute peak of possible human performance. We don't know what was exactly in this formula, but we can speculate based on the effects it produces in Cap. Whatever it was, it would have to mess with Cap's genes. Dr. Sebastian Alvarado, who you might recognize from my video on the Hulk's hue, has a theory about this too, and it's based on the fact that we actually know what genes in our DNA are associated with things like muscle growth and how much oxygen our blood can carry. So if we could inject him with a formula that suppresses certain genes and hyperactivates other ones, we could induce something like Cap's amazing transformation. As Dr. Alvarado points out, one way to have the super soldier formula seek out and change a part of Captain's DNA would be with a technique something like CRISPR, or clustered regularly interspaced short palindromic repeats. It's a way to add or delete information from our genetic blueprint. The CRISPR technique is based on how bacteria protect themselves from viruses. When viral DNA is detected, the bacteria sends out two single strands of RNA and then, using a protein called Cas9, locates a section of that DNA with the same code. The RNA then locks onto that piece and cuts it there, disabling it. Scientists then figured out that this same process could be used to add or delete genetic information from any organism, including humans. The CRISPR technique could cut DNA, deactivating some gene, but it could also cut DNA and provide another copy, a mutated copy of that gene, to change the way that it's expressed. Since we know what genes are associated with things like muscle growth and athletic performance, using a technique like CRISPR could feasibly beef up Steve Rogers. But the secret super soldier program has no time for lengthy clinical trials and incremental improvements. That's where the so-called Vita Rays come in. Researchers are still tinkering with this technique, but light-activated drug delivery systems are something that we're looking into. The idea is that first some nanoscale material would house some drug or medicine. Then, when hit with a certain wavelength of light, these materials would open up in some way and deliver their drugs inside to a patient at a specific place in their body or at a specific time. If Steve Rogers was injected with some gene editing formula inside some light activated nanomaterials, then feasibly the super soldier formula and Vita chamber could work in tandem to create the perfect soldier. But that kind of work is decades away. Why? Because science. Hail Hydra. Want more science? Check out my last video on how Daredevil can fight crime without being able to see. Subscribe to Nerdist for more videos. If you want Because Science 2 days earlier than anyone else, subscribe to Vessel at vessel.com/Nerdist. And as always, if you have any comments or questions, hit me up in the comments section below. Thanks.